Well, few stories are sadder than the story of the drunk driver who kills an innocent victim. Often the drivers have already had their licenses suspended for previous events, but kept on driving. Tonight, Vermont is a big step closer to adopting technology that might be more effective in keeping drunks off the road. And News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter is live in our Vermont newsroom tonight with the details on this. Stu?
Well, Gabrielle, we reported on this back in January when the ignition interlock idea first surfaced at the Capitol. State police and state prosecutors now back the idea, convincing lawmakers that the current penalties for DUI in Vermont just don't work.
Those voting yes, 141. Those voting no, zero.
The House vote was unanimous for Vermont to join 47 other states that utilize ignition interlocks to help stop the drunk driver. The devices require an operator to blow into a tube before the ignition will start and retests drivers every so often to ensure they're not under the influence. Mothers Against Drunk Drivers and the Vermont State Police all backed the technology because simply revoking a driver's license, the current penalty, doesn't get people off the road.
There's overwhelming evidence that, particularly in a rural place like Vermont, people will continue to drive without their licenses. Estimates anywhere from 50 to 75% will continue to drive without their licenses.
Under the bill, first-time offenders would have the option of installing the device at their expense. For those too poor to afford it,
if you can afford to drink, you can probably afford the $2 to $3 a day for this interlock ignition device. It might not be a choice you'd want to make.
Though voluntary, the ignition device would mean first-time offenders could keep driving legally, no license suspension.
On balance, I voted yes, but I do have big reservations about the message that it sends out to the public.
But the governor is on board.
I think Vermonters would like to see it in place as quickly as possible.
Version that passed today would take effect in mid-2011, middle of next year. In the meantime, giving the Motor Vehicle Department time to work out all of the details on how this would work. The Senate version is more reserved on that timeline, but, you know, with a 139-0 vote like the one we saw today, somehow this seems like the kind of legislation that's going to get all worked out in these last few days of the session in Montpelier. Live in the Vermont newsroom tonight, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5. Gabrielle?